Hey, Rosie, I got an exit.
No! Are you crazy, man? Right in the middle of my road, I'm hot.
I'm a little bored, huh?
Rosie, I need a car.
I'm going to my lot.
Lot's closed.
I know that I'm here, ain't I?
So I want the 57 T-Bird.
Oh.
What the hell you say?
What happened to the car?
Got ripped off and got burned out.
I'm going to lock the car and we'll talk about it.
I need it, Rosie.
Man, you're breaking my roll.
I need it.
Damn. You're paining my back, man. I'm paining my back.
There's 57 T-Bird, and it's going to cost you plenty because it's a classic.
Send me a bill, Rosie, thanks.
Okay.
Seven out.
I'll kill him. There he go. Okay, guys, welcome back to another project. This one is going to be the 57 T-Bird from the 1978 hit TV show Vegas, starring Robert Urich as the enigmatic Tanna. Robert Urich actually was probably is my all-time favorite actor. He was something else. But anyway, this is the AMT 57 Thunderbird, molded in red, built to be the car from the show. Let's take a look inside and see what we got. Okay, so we opened the box. The box, when I got it, the box was open. The parts inside were sealed in the plastic. We've undone that, so we don't have to listen to the crinkle, crinkle, crinkle. And let's take a look and see inside. I'll tell you right off the bat, I'm not that impressed with this kit. It's got some, it's just, well, I guess for the time it's okay, but it just seems like it's really in need of some updating and stuff. But here's our chrome tree. It's a very big chrome tree for very little parts. You can see here we got our steel wheels. We got the front grille and bumper, which looks pretty good, actually. I'm actually even happy with the type of chrome. It doesn't look like it's over the top. Hopefully we can save this and use it as it is. Give it a nice wash on the grille. This is the cover for the rear wheel for the spare tire. We've got our rear bumper, we've got our hubcaps, and we've got our very thick, very big window frame for the front windshield. Alright, there's also a shifter, some extra gauges down here. We've got a optional tack and gear shifter here also. Alright. I think it's under 60 parts altogether. This isn't going to be a very in-depth thing, but here's the motor. Not much to it. Molded in red. We've got the interior. Let's see. We got the roof. We got the cover for the spare tire on the back bumper. This here is our dash for the interior of the car. See, not bad detail, really. It'll need some work, you know, just to, it's a nice detail painting to get it to pop a little bit. Let's see, what else do we got? A very big, thick hunk of plastic with one rear cover for the tire. You know, the skirt, a lot of flash on there, needs to be cleaned up. We got a heater hose. We got the steering wheel. Nothing huge, nothing shocking with the top. I'm not sure what this is offhand. Maybe the firewall. Not sure. These are the mounts for the wheels, because these got the, this kit comes with the steel bars for the wheels. Alright. Which I happen to be missing one of those. but I'm sure I could figure something out. Here's the glass. Thick, distorted, but again, it is what we got. We've got the tires. Okay. Really not too badly detailed. They got some nice tread in them. They've got some labeling on them. Just got this big honking center part we have to cut out. All four tires are here. I've got one sun visor. We've got the hood. Okay. Some scratches in it. A little bit of a divot over here from where it was connected to the tree. Has to be cleaned up a bit. All the parts are going to need some real attention. Heater box for the engine compartment. That's really about it. Rear window for the roof. Yeah, that's about it. Like I said, I only got one bar. I can figure something out, but only got one of these. And then the worst part about this kit, the part that's got me most frustrated, is this. Here's your chassis. All molded, one big hunk of plastic. Now the detail underneath isn't really horrible, but it's just, I don't know, just kind of, ugh. Now I thought about two big injector marks that go over top of the framework here. I had thought about replacing the kit bashing this kit with the 56 T-Bird I have from AMT. Same scale and everything, but a lot more detail. Individual detail, the frame, the rear end, everything is separate from the chassis. So I figured that would be a lot better detail. Problem is the chassis from that kit is a lot bigger and it wouldn't fit. So I'm going to have to work with this one. So, yuck. But it is what it is, right? Some of these kits give us a challenge. This is one of them. Yeah, no leaf springs here. It's just a solid bar. Oh, it's ugly. And if I want to cut this out, put rear leaf springs in and another rear, it's just a lot of cutting. I'm not sure if it's worth it. I might just kind of just do it the way it is. But anyway, you know, this also doesn't really do anything to make it be Dan Tanna's car either. This is just really a Thunderbird. They didn't give you anything to make it stand out as Dan Tanna's car. Let me see something actually. I just realized I don't even have the not even any decals with it. Decals are gone because that was the only thing they really came with was, I think there was a license plate for it that said Tanna on it. But I can make that up. That's not a big deal. But really, there's nothing on here. Otherwise, it makes this to be his car. They don't have the phone on the inside. They don't have the antenna for the outside. So, you know, except for throwing his picture on it and the Vegas on here, it's not really anything special that makes it Vegas car. But anyway. So that's our story. Again, one of my favorite shows, all-time favorite actor. So I hope you'll grab a glass of milk and stay tuned for the ride. So till next time, guys, be strong. And next we have the body, okay? The body has everything in it. Let's see if I can get you in a little bit here. You can see the molded in Thunderbird, the gills here, the body lines. It's not horrible. It needs to be cleaned up a little bit. It's especially rough here at the shoulders where the back fender meets the door. It's a little ugly, but we have to fix that. All around the cutout here is really rough. It needs to be smoothed out. You know, big blobs of plastic here. Also, the the lines here just a little shallow. I think they're going to get, with primer and paint and everything, they might get a little bit obscure, so I might have to redo these lines a little bit, scribe them out a little bit, make them better. But there's the engine compartment there. Again, all molded in red. Nothing special. Just a ordinary red T-bird.